There's nothing like driving a jet car.
As soon as you see it, you want to just be
280 miles per hour and a quarter of a mile in just 5.5 seconds. No brakes, just parachutes.
This sport is extremely dangerous.
You know, my life is on the line every time I get in the car.
Every part is pushed to its limits. The first time our product's gonna be tested at 280 miles an hour, we want our parts to be as safe as possible, so if something goes wrong, our drivers, they don't get hurt. Jet racing is our wow factor. We do a lot of fabrication, prototyping, small production run manufacturing in our facility. The jet engines we use are General Electric J85. They're out of the F5 Freedom Fighter that the US military uses. But we take them onto a custom-built chassis about 26 feet long, strap them to a driver inside that. We build a custom afterburner that doubles the output of the engine.
I started racing when I was 16 years old. In the entire world, I'm one of 5 female jet dragster drivers.
Our steering wheels are what you call butterfly steering wheels. They have little grooves for your fingers to fit in.
The steering wheels are typically made for bigger hands. Because my hands are so much smaller,
I don't even use those grooves. I kind of just shove my hand up in the corner.
The drivers have to reach specific buttons.
If I can't reach this button, then I can't drive the car properly.
The driver's life depends on this steering wheel. If it breaks or something goes wrong with this component, then they will most likely crash.
So we decided to 3D print a steering wheel that would fit my hand exactly.
Quality, precision, and safety are probably the biggest factors for us, especially when it comes to the racing, because someone's life is on the line. We're asking, can we make it stronger? Can we make it faster? Can we make it lighter? And can we make it more customized? This is the aluminum steering wheel we would order from our vendor. It'd take about 8 days to get to us. It would weigh more, and it doesn't actually fit the driver's hands exactly how we would want it to.
The original aluminum part, we had to put in a lot of buttonholes, a big top plate on the top of it. It's just a lot of extra work when we can just make it one solid part. And we really needed to keep the strength of aluminum. So the Markforged Onyx with the carbon fiber inlay lets us meet that aluminum strength.
Continuous fiber reinforcement is extremely important for us. It gives strength in certain areas that you know you need it. You don't have to put it everywhere. So you can make your strength specific to the area you want, and it really beefs up that component. And a little bit goes a long way, we've learned. So we added on these bolt-on grips, and then we added in this cross member to actually stiffen up the whole thing.
Get in, try and break this steering wheel.
I'll try.
All right. What switches are, the grip thickness, any of that? It's easy to change now.
Yeah, no, I think everything's perfect on it.
You can't break it?
Can't break it.
I want you to break it.
I don't think she could. I don't think I could.
Does it bend? It moves. It's flexing.
Can you do that with the other one?
Yeah. This one doesn't move at all. I'm struggling to even make it think about moving. Yeah.
Markforged machines are extremely accurate. The parts we're printing are within the thousands of the part we designed. I've never seen or heard of anything like simulation software that Markforged has provided for this testing. It was able to give us confidence through the iterations that we were getting a better and better design every time before we even have to print it. This is going to allow people to start really testing, optimizing their designs. They don't have to print 10 different parts, they can do it all in simulation. The print bed on the Markforged X7 is large enough to where we could print the steering wheel with all the grips in one print. I hit go on Friday afternoon, I came back Monday morning, and I was able to take all the parts off we needed and assemble the steering wheel right then and there.
What used to take us 8 days just to get a part shipped, if they have it in stock, we can now 3D print whatever part it might be in 2 days or less.
It's a game changer for us. So we want to bring that all in-house, and we can streamline everything so anything can go from one car to the next. If something breaks, you don't need to carry 20 different spare parts, you carry one. Many people believe 3D printing is hobbyist and you don't get this great finish, but businesses like ours, we can see the benefit to spending and getting those high quality printers like Markforged, and you get those parts that come off the line and are ready to go directly into your race car. I think this new Markforged software is going to be significant, and it's going to change the way people can manufacture.